mission statement. Silicon Valley mission statement is to create an app that can compress any file and make it smaller. To integrate this program through many platforms, making a positive impact on our planet. To build PeedPiper into a large organization. Team Connect's mission statement is to take life experiences from the episodes and provide real-life examples of management. We will use these experiences to create entertaining yet educational videos. Plot. We will watch Richard and his friends struggle with many decisions as they develop and launch their new company. Each member is going to adapt and grow throughout the season. We will see the group develop as they learn from other influences what it takes to run a company. We will learn from this group the qualities and challenges of a manager. Our target market is anyone who's looking to start their own business. Character profiles.
Dinesh is an excellent JavaScript web developer. He's the only one in the group with the skill, making him a valuable asset to the company. He's constantly butting heads with Guilfoyle, searching for power. Until there is a clear management structure, the conflicts will continue unless managed appropriately, which is highly unproductive for the company. Dinesh is extremely blunt, generally occurring when he hears something that is not the truth or even little from it. Dinesh is very shy when it comes to interacting with women, since he was raised in Pakistan with conservative Eastern traditions. He frequently references his experience from Pakistan. He became a naturalized citizen in 2010, unlike Guilfoyle, who was an illegal Canadian alien until quite recently. Dinesh's libertarian political views shape most of his choices and the situations he's put into.
Ehrlich owns the property, or incubator, that PeedPiper is run out of. Because of this, Ehrlich owns 10% of the company and sits on the board of the company. He is extremely cocky and douchey, and the rest of the team knows it. In fact, in Season 1, Episode 2, Dinesh states that Ehrlich is pretty much good at being an a-hole. Ehrlich demonstrates that he is better than everyone else around him and tends to try to boss others around in an aggressive manner. Another example from Season 1, Episode 2 is when Ehrlich hires a stripper to come to his house and perform for the others, only to force Richard to pick up the tab since he is the CEO. Ehrlich is a regular user of marijuana and is not afraid to let that be known. Time after time throughout the seasons, he will flat out ask people if they smoke weed or if they want to smoke with him. Although Ehrlich is everything I stated before, he also cares deeply about the team around him and offers some great advice at times. Ehrlich proves several times throughout the episodes that he is loyal and willing to go out on a limb for those around him. One of my favorite scenes was when he told Richard that he needs to be more of an a-hole in order to run his business and have more control over what happens.
Guilfoyle. He is the brains of the network security of the company, as he is mainly in charge of maintaining the integrity of the system against vulnerabilities. For the most part, he loves to play jokes on other characters, but mainly his friend Dinesh. Retrospectively, his managerial traits are strong as far as disturbance handling, page 16, since he assists in detecting and assisting in rectifying data transmission problems, such as packet sniffing or DDoS attacks. He isn't extremely talented at coding, which is part of the final product, but rather, he engages in support activities, page 93, required to keep the system going. As far as personality traits, he is extremely cynical and creates an environment that helps all other members of PeedPiper to question those exterior to the company. In the organizational structure, he is essentially a part of the lowest tier of membership and is mainly control of the operational plans.
Jared is the head of business development at PeedPiper. He left an executive position at Hooli to help his team build a new company. Though the entire team doesn't mesh with his personality, he is essential to keeping the team together. He keeps the team organized and on the right path. He lives and breathes strategic management and loves having a plan for everything. The team prefers to go with the flow, which can make it hard for Jared. He is very maternal towards the other characters, making sure everyone is happy. Jared focuses on rational decision-making and loves to be prepared for everything. Under decisional roles, Jared is a great resource allocator. He has high level of conceptual skills based on his focus on rational decision thinking. Based on Jaren's concern to make everyone happy, he believes in the utilitarian approach.
Monica is a gentle by nature, but a move by nurture young woman with an open mind for technology. Her humble but straightforward personality makes her a trustworthy and respected figurehead, leader, and liaison. She possesses significant wisdom beyond her years, particularly in the technology industry. When Monica recognizes the competitive advantages that exist within an algorithm created for the Pied Piper app, she uses not only her interpersonal skills to negotiate with Richard, but also her innovative managerial thinking to encourage her boss to invest in this idea that would deliver superior quality and face minimal substitutions. Monica possesses both the professional demeanor to communicate confidently with bigwigs who respect her ability to lead and direct, and the sincere attitude to build the confidence of the little man on the totem pole, who expects nothing but good intentions from her, and trusts that she will effectively use her political skills to connect him to other individuals with power.
Richard is an incredibly smart tech programmer from Silicon Valley. While developing a music app called Pied Piper, it is discovered that Richard actually invented an algorithm to compress files that has endless possibilities that could be worth billions. Richard's discovery draws interest fast, and Richard must quickly learn to run a business and make decisions as a manager. Personality-wise, Richard is shy but honest. While avoiding major confrontation, he will speak up when necessary. Throughout the show, we see Richard grow as a person, and as a manager for Pied Piper, he is forced to navigate the business world for the first time. At first, Richard struggles. He does not have the communication skills needed to pitch Pied Piper to his wealthy investor. We see Richard is forced to come up with a solid business model and make a deal for $200,000 for 5% of the Pied Piper, legitimizing Pied Piper as a major company. We see Richard encounter many issues with his company due to inexperience, but we see Richard overcome every obstacle and grow into his new CEO role very quickly. In this episode, we go over the classical decision-making model to decide if Jared should call about his egg. Jared is watching a live stream of an egg, hoping to see it hatch. We will watch Jared identify his dilemma if calling about the egg is like Schrodinger's cat. We will then watch him go over his alternatives and select to make the call. This decision causes the museum guy to fall from taking the camera down. We will then evaluate the results of Jared's decision-making process.
Episode 3, Leadership. After a long and prosperous sequence of events, Pied Piper grows into the company Richard has dreamed it would be. Unfortunately, times have changed. The board of directors that have formed after the formation of Pied Piper as a corporation seek to oust Richard as CEO. His leadership skills, page 206, are tested to the limit as he must overcome his introverted personality in order to regain his position as CEO. Unable to maintain a steady stream of core competence, page 96, the board of directors have finally found a CEO they feel has had effective leadership, page 208, in his previous tech companies. The new CEO, Jack Baker, interacts with Richard in a less than fiery exchange, prompting the two to have to work together to make things work. Richard gains experience and personal power, page 211, which later converts into legitimate power, page 211, after some time. The board of Pied Piper once again chooses Richard as the CEO.
This class has definitely taught me a manager has many sub-jobs to ensure that not only the customer is happy, but the employees and stockholders are happy too. Managers are constantly learning to balance everyone's needs to run a successful company. One of the most important parts of being a manager is expecting that there will always be change. Only change itself is unchanging. Though we might not always understand the root cause of the change or enjoy this change, we need to learn to implement this change in the most fluid way possible. Resistance from your employees is almost guaranteed, but with the right tools, information, you can use the change process to ensure the team fluidly can take that change.
Management is a concept that just can't be taught from book. It's something that a worker must experience firsthand in order to truly be able to effectively and efficiently manage his subordinates to do the job right. A foreman from the olden times would watch over crowds of workers without any real span of control. This led to inefficiencies in output that directly impacted the company's bottom line. Through careful study, Frederick Taylor, the father of scientific management, helped build principles creating the scientific approach to improving the effectiveness of managers. His contribution to the concept of management helped others to be able to create systems in place with the goal of improving output. The best way to improve management is to look at the practice objectively and hypothesize answers to complex questions. Hello there, future managers and entrepreneurs. My name is Tej DeVore. I am a full-time receiving team lead at Macy's, full-time accounting student with the goals of someday becoming a CFO and helping other countries in developing. Accomplishing such arduous tasks would require a lot of background information and training in the discipline of management. Fortunately, taking this class has helped me to understand what is required through team building assignments and scenarios that fit effortlessly into the real world through the exploration of communicative softwares and teamwork to ensure that a final product is finished.
I will say, working in a group has certainly been great practice for working in the real world. You learn to overcome objectives that you would face in the workforce.
One of my biggest recommendations is to get ahead and go over the syllabus and break everything down with your team. This will make it totally easier in the long run and keep the... Another great tip is to start a group chat and keep it running. That way you guys are always communicating with each other.
As things change with the expansion of technology, managers, like scientists, must constantly be using technology to the best of their advantage. This includes monitoring, predicting, executing, etc., to create the best output with the least amount of scarce resources. By taking this class, it is necessary to take advantage of online communication in order to stay current with other members of the group for projects. This firsthand experience goes beyond what is read and written in the text, as decision-making is spread between all members. This fosters an early representation of how management works in the workforce and prepares students to take on new challenges.
I made it, and I still have all my hair. And it's still brown, or at least most of it is. Hi, my name is Tanya Wilkins. After weeks of building my knowledge of management concepts, I have a better understanding of how the wheels turn within the corporate setting. I have also learned tools for working as part of a group to accomplish tasks more efficiently. I was admittedly intimidated at the idea of working with a group, as I feared my lack of computer skills might hinder my ability to communicate effectively and to contribute to the group. Though limited in technological skills, I was able to create scripting that could then be applied to the episodes of Silicon Valley to demonstrate the management concepts being studied. Combined with the technological enhancements added by my teammates, we have thus far successfully met every challenge presented to us. I recommend meeting in person as early in the semester as possible and selecting a strong leader. I also recommend trying to set deadlines for group assignments that are earlier than the actual deadlines for submission to allow room for any mishaps. Good luck!